All right. Hey, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. You are tuned into the Status Network, the live TV channel, and this is the Conversation Corner with your host, author Andrew Snorton. And let's have a conversation. As always, every second and fourth Wednesday at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, we bring in some wonderful people doing wonderful things across business, entertainment, the community, and more. So before we get into our guests, we're going to do a couple of station announcements as well as announcements on yours truly. First off, with the Status Network, we thank you not only for supporting this show and this channel, but the entire Status Network family of channels, shows, programming hosts, personalities, you name it, we've got it here. The best way to view our show tonight is visit statusnetwork.net, click on the menu for channels, click on the menu for live TV, and go to the Conversation Corner, and you're good to go. For those of you that have space on your smartphones, make some space on your smartphones, download the Status Network app, click on channels, click on live TV, and you are good to go. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, Periscope, other social media platforms, Status Network, and or live TV. For those of you that have Roku, go ahead and tune in right now, as well as Amazon Fire Stick. And last but not least, you need to make sure you keep track of the host. From what I understand, he moves a lot. That's what I hear. But anyway, make sure to add me on Author Andrew Snorton on Facebook, as it's streaming live right now, as well as Author A. Snorton on Instagram for more organic and behind-the-scenes look. So again, those are the best ways, and we appreciate you guys. And now, a couple of quick things about the author. So one of the first things that I am proud and excited to know about is the Author Academy Awards. And I'll tell you what, back in February is when the voting open, and there you see it on the screen. I made it, y'all, because of you, both of my books, and that's a big deal. My first book I wrote in 2017, my second one 2018, both of them made the cut. They're amongst the top 1,000 choices, which means, yeah, you had 5,100 people applying. Between now and August 24th, if you'll do me the privilege of going to authoracademyawards.com, click on the menu for the 2019 awards, go to the category for best memoir, and there you'll see Deeper Than Your Deepest Sleep, Thoughts on Love with Joseph Snorton. So that's the black book there that I'm holding in my left hand that's on the right-hand side. And then go to the category for self-help, as you'll see 9 Stories of Faith. So voting ends on the 24th, and thank each and every one of you for supporting. And speaking of support, this coming Saturday, August the 17th, you get a chance to catch me in the SIP. That's right. For those of you in Jackson, Mississippi, Clinton, Mississippi, yeah, I know my geography, but you need to make your way to the Literary Lawn Party. That's the Mississippi Book Festival taking place this Saturday, August the 17th. Join me at my section at the Author's Alley from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. I'll have both books available for signing and purchase and all that good stuff. So come out and not only support me, well, of course I want you to support me, but even bigger, this is one of the quietly bigger festivals, not only in the Southeast, but the country. This is the 5th year they're doing the Mississippi Book Festival, and I think they drew about 5,000 or 6,000 people last year. So you know where you need to be on Saturday. Saturday in the SIP. You definitely want to make sure you do that. But of course, I do things in Metro Atlanta too. So if you would do me a favor and mark your calendar for August the 25th. August the 25th, join me at one of my favorite spaces and places in the Far East Metro. We're taking it to Conyers, y'all. Pseudo Bar and Grill from 3 to 5 p.m. is the book signing portion. I'll have both books available, as well as another special thing that I'll get to in a moment. And then from 5 to 8 p.m., I like to call it a late day party. So yes, there are going to be beverage specials, which means this is for the grown folks in the building, 21 and older. Nothing personal, 21 and older. And because of when my birthday happens, August 31st, we're going to get the end of that weekend, the beginning of the week, off to a good start. So come on out and join me from 3 to 5 for the signing portion, 5 to 8 to kick back, and chop it up and all those types of things. And we're just going to go ahead and make the magic happen. So thank you to Pseudo Bar and Grill. And now, of course, one of the things I'm excited to talk about. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I have another book coming out, but this time it's of the audiobook variety. That is right. What you're about to hear is the little promo or teaser for the upcoming release of the author's mixtape. That is right, the author's mixtape. Not just any author, but mine, the author's mixtape. So we're going to give you a little snippet of the poetry, spoken word, the organic nature, because it was really all done freestyle. But we'll have you guys take a quick listen for just a moment.
What's going on, y'all? This is author Andrew Snorton, and today's project is the author's mixtape, volume one, From H to O, looking at things a little bit differently compared to other poetry and spoken word pieces. This is done in partnership with Third Level Entertainment Music Group, and the way we did our spoken word is a little bit different. What you're about to hear is purely organic. In other words, the topics were picked, given to me. Then I had 10 minutes to come up with something, and they had 10 minutes to come up with instrumentals. You'll hear two instrumental tracks and four traditional tracks. So sit back, relax, take it all in, and remember, this is the first of what will be soon to come, the author's mixtape.
And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. That's the intro for the author's mixtape. So shouts to Third Level Entertainment, who is working in partnership with me on this, as well as Canis Major for handling a couple other things. So we'll have that release info real soon. But as you heard, it is totally organic. Now, speaking of organic, most of you know that I am a sports fan, and growing up, baseball was one of my things. And I've been real excited with the help of the network and as well as the work I do under Creative Community Solutions to do a minor league baseball series called Nothing Minor. Since mid-June, I've been able to cover ground in Gwinnett, which is a AAA affiliate of the Atlanta Braves, Chattanooga, which is a AA affiliate of the Cincinnati Reds, Greenville, which is a single-A affiliate of the Boston Red Sox, Greensboro, which is the single-A affiliate of the Pittsburgh Pirates, Birmingham, which is a AA affiliate of the Chicago White Sox, and then I made a return visit to Gwinnett on July 31st for sports fans, you know that is the trade deadline, which is a really big deal. So I've been real excited that some of the players I've interviewed, including Travis Demeritt, who was subsequently traded from Gwinnett to the Detroit Tigers system on the trade deadline. He's actually now the starting right fielder for the Detroit Tigers. So shouts to Travis Demeritt. What you're about to see right now is a pregame interview that was done at my most recent visit to Gwinnett with Tuki Toussaint, who has actually spent time between the Gwinnett team as well as the Atlanta Braves. Let's take a look at his conversation with us.
We are back here in Gwinnett for the home of the Stripers. This is for our Nothing Minor series. And today's obviously been a very interesting day with it being the trade deadline and everything. But we're here speaking with one of the players, Tuki Toussaint. How are you doing, sir?
Good, yourself?
Hey, doing great, doing great. Share with our viewers, first off, during the course of this year, of course you're always looking at improving. What's one key thing that you think you've been able to focus on and you're seeing your growth and seeing your progression?
I'd definitely say fastball command. I mean, getting out there is being able to get out and with my fastball and throwing my fastball where I want to. And just being able to slow the game down more and more each time out.
Okay.
Definitely something I've been working on.
And on top of that, what's one thing that you see of the many parts of your game you want to continue to build upon? What's one thing that you see that, let me just take a little bit extra time on fine-tuning in order to get things closer where I want to be?
I'd say my delivery. I mean, I know everybody says, like, during the game, you can't worry about your delivery, so I go out there and compete during the game, but during my bullpen and playing catch and stuff like that, I definitely work on my delivery, make sure my side's up, I'm staying back, and stuff like that, that when I get out there, it makes it a lot easier. And if I'm struggling, I know what I can go back to. So definitely my delivery and fastball command, I mean, you need that first.
Correct. Yeah, and you said a whole lot. Now, one thing that you've got a different vantage point compared to other players is that you have spent time here on the AAA level. You have spent time on the major league level. What would you say is one of the big things that you've learned during the course of this year, given your experience playing on both levels?
You got to be consistent. I mean, that's the biggest thing. Like, consistency is key. If you're a bullpen guy, 8 out of 10 games, you better be on your A game. You know what I mean? I mean, going out there, putting up zeros. Your starter, it rates you out of starts, 35 starts, 25 to 30 good ones, and then 5 all right ones. But I definitely say consistency, and that's the biggest key, honestly.
Okay. Okay. And then for our younger viewers, as we have different people that watch their playing from Little League to American Legion, college, even at different levels of the minor leagues, of course there's a lot of lessons that you've learned. And for lack of a term, there's a lot of wisdom that you have, even with your time already. What's one key piece of advice you'd like to share for people as they pursue playing this game?
I'd say be yourself. You're good enough wherever you're at. Just be yourself and be your consistent self.
Okay. Well, I mean, you've pretty much covered a whole lot. As we said earlier, number one, thank you for taking and making time. Number two, continued progression, not only individually but collectively. Not only best wishes for today, but best wishes for beyond.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot for taking
time.
Nice
meeting you.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Okay.
And many thanks again, not only to the Gwinnett Stripers, but Tuki Toussaint, who I did that interview with, as he has split time between AAA Gwinnett and the Atlanta Braves. The next interview you're going to see is a little bit different, as it's an interview with Chris Jones, who is actually an umpire supervisor. So first off, I didn't know those existed, but he's got a great story. So we're going to take a look at this segment right quick with Chris Jones.
Hey there, ladies and gentlemen. This is Andrew Snorton with the Status Network in partnership with Creative Community Solutions. And this is an added wrinkle to our Nothing Minor series. We have right here working with one of the officials for Major League Baseball. Could you let us know who you are and what capacity do you have with Major League Baseball?
Yeah, my name is Chris Jones. I'm one of the umpire supervisors for Major League Baseball. My particular role is AAA coordinator. And I'm coordinating, one, our coverage, our observation, trying to keep a structure on how we are going to instruct the umpires. I run our conference calls, which is a, just more of our meetings on when we discuss the umpires. I've been doing it since 2005. I umpired for 11 years and came off the field in 97. And started to work with the minor leagues in 1997, transition over to Major League Baseball in 2005.
What would you say is one of the more, I'll say, intriguing aspects of what you do? Like you said before, it's part, I'll say, consult, part grading and guiding, but what's one of the more intriguing things that you'd say about what you do?
Well, you know, just to see somebody from the cradle to the commencement, and to me, that's what we get out of it, to see the development of a young umpire. We take them down the Arizona Fall League, just keeping a tab on the guy's development or lack thereof and making a judgment on whether or not they should continue or they should work on plan B. And we try to let them know that, you know, if plan B is in the process, they need to get on plan B, or you know, there's a good opportunity for them to advance to the major league level. Unfortunately, at the major league level, the turnaround isn't as big as it is for a player. And if you have that hot shot umpire, he can't displace somebody that's already in the major leagues. You know, that's all dependent on supply and demand. And the major league umpires, you know, they could work 25, 30 years or even longer. A lot of guys are working longer. Our average career span is 27 years. So when the turnover is slim, it's tough. But, you know, the guys, we keep them in the system. And so we may have a guy as a call-up umpire work 5, 6, 7 years as a call-up umpire. Our recent hire, Chad Whitson, who just got hired this past July, he was at it for 15 years as a minor league umpire before he got the job in the major leagues just a couple weeks ago.
Okay. What would you say, words of wisdom or insight, because like you said, you have experience of having been an umpire, and now you're doing it, for like a term, on the other side of the fence. And like you said before, what was that average career span for an umpire?
For the major leagues, it's 27. Once a guy gets hired, the average is 27 years. We have a retention program at the minor league level that we have to, Major League Baseball, show interest in your work. Or if you get to retention level, which is 3 years, and then we ask them to go to their plan B. And, you know, so that they're young enough to start a second career.
Right, they can go ahead and transition.
That's right.
What would you say of your years of experience, what's one set of words of wisdom or piece of advice or insight you'd like to give people? Because I know we've done it on the playing level, but
we don't always hear about it on the umpire level.
Yeah, it takes a different mindset. You got to be thick-skinned. Your name's not going to be in the highlights unless you've, in their perception, or been perceived to make a mistake. So you got to have thick skin. We teach that. We also have umpire camps where we give opportunities and scholarship umpires to umpire schools, something that I was not afforded, and it took me 2 years to save the money to go to umpire school. But the Major League Baseball umpire camps, you know, we teach them from day one, this is the mindset you need to have as an umpire. You need to be thick skinned, and you can't think that when you make a call that they're attacking the person, they're just attacking the uniform, and you just happen to be wearing the uniform.
Okay, well, great. Well, thanks a lot for taking and making the time. Thanks for giving us a lot of insight on a part of the game that a lot of people, like you said, don't necessarily pay attention to unless something happens and it doesn't go somebody's way.
That's right.
But thanks for taking and making the time. Best wishes with all you're working on for today and beyond.
Absolutely. Thank you, Andrew.
Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm. Great work.
That is the Nothing Minor series that we are doing. We have, I know this Friday, our next stop will be at Jackson. I know, I'm going to be in the SIP. I'm doing more than just the book festival. So I'm covering the game on Friday and then pivoting on Saturday. So enough about me. Now this is the fun part of the show where I get a chance to actually interview some awesome people doing awesome things. Ms. Charla Mitchell in the building.
Hello,
how are you doing?
I'm good. How are you doing, Andrew?
I am doing great. Good. And I tell you what, like I said, every guest I'm really excited is doing some really exciting things. But before you get into all the awesome stuff you're doing, please give our viewers a little bit of a background of where you're from, where you went to school, and a couple of things you did before you made your full pivot into what you're doing now.
Okay. Again, I'm Charla. I go by Charla Rochelle. I'm a fashion designer, originally from Columbia, Maryland. I came to Atlanta, Georgia for school. I attended Clark Atlanta University, class of 2000. And now I'm full-time fashion designer, business owner. I have a shop in the old Fourth Ward called Concoction, the Workshop, where I clothe, create, consult. I've been sewing for over 30 years. I do women's ready-to-wear, and I'm all things fashion, and especially in terms of playing a part in leadership and mentoring and all that good stuff when it comes to fashion and apparel.
You are just the professional with a sense of stewardship and everything. Pause for a minute and walk through with our viewers. Now, you shared a couple of tidbits, a sewing background for a little bit over 30 years. So it seems like design and the creatives have always been a part of who you are. Could you explain to our viewers, when did you know, like, you know how all of us have something that we always do, and that might be like that hobby or that release. Could you walk through with our viewers, when was that moment for you where you're like, this is one of the things that I do, but it's really an extension of who I am, and I want to take it further. Walk us through that process.
Well, I've always been a child of the arts. Really, my first love is dance. I'll dance and continue to dance forever. I really got into fashion. My mom put me in a sewing class. It was a camp in fourth grade, and I was like, okay, we're going to a sewing camp, which was cool. Before even going into that, I was always a kid that always walked my own and doing my own thing. Mm-hmm. So when it came to clothes and apparel, you know, it wasn't what my parents, of my request of what I would want my parents to purchase me. They more did the style of what you're going to wear, what you need to wear, mm-hmm. not what you want. So with that, I was like, all right, so I can create my own, you know, style from there, and my own originality. So that's kind of how fashion came into play, between going to sewing classes and sewing camps. Sewing became my therapy. So I continue to take that on, as well as just extended family, my godparents. I always label them as like my stylist icons, and how I really got into the whole look of styling and learning about those high-end brands and so forth, mm-hmm. like that. So my pursuit to go to college was both of a passion of fashion design and also medicine, but I chose to walk, you know, my passion and love for the arts.
And that's amazing. And the key thing is, even with different things you picked up along the way, you incorporate something, whether it's the thought process or some of the approaches. Walk through with our viewers, under your business umbrella, what are a few of the branches? So obviously I know it's going to be fashion design, mm-hmm. but walk through with our viewers again, under your company, these are the key branches or key threads. I know, clothing threads, I know, terrible.
But
some of the things that you do under your business umbrella.
Under my business umbrella, so I established my parent company, which is Hazel Eyes Fashion House and Company, LLC. I wanted to ensure if I went into the entrepreneurial world that I would have my own fashion house and not work for a fashion house. So with that entail, under my parent company, I have my clothing brand, which is CR Clothing Company, Charla Rochelle, my first and middle name. And then my other branch, I have actually my shop, which is Concoction the Workshop, where again, I clothe, create, and consult, looking, of course, to expand that and put it into other cities. And now I've opened up another venture, which is called Cloth. This stands for Collaborators Lounge or The Happenings. And that is more of bringing creative businesses together, creating a collaborative environment for other creatives to sell products, and really extension of Concoction the Workshop, but actually really putting it out in the community so that these businesses can be supported, as well as we are paying attention to those businesses that actually make and create and design and are innovative, and you see the genuine love in what they do.
And you tapped into a number of different things, and I really want to spend a little bit extra time on cloth from the standpoint of bringing the creative community together. Mm-hmm. And creative is not just fashion. That can go into arts or writing or a whole, you know, wide range of things. And another thing that you really emphasize is the ability to better connect and better interface. So walk through with our viewers what's upcoming under the umbrella of, I mean, I can't really say the umbrella, but under the extension for cloth, because there's something big coming up there viewers really need to, across the board, be fully aware of.
Okay. Yes, so cloth, my first venture, I wanted to do a marketplace. And of course, it has to be a fashionable one, but I wanted to include anything of art, and I think of art as good health. So why not involve food? I think culinary is an art. So it's Cloth Times Collaborators. That's the name of the event, Cloth Times Collaborators. It's a fashionable brunch marketplace. So with that in mind, I included, again, culinary. I did applications in terms of those that would be interested to be vendors. You know, what makes your product a wow factor? What was your wow moment? It's something to where I want businesses to also, I guess, showcase themselves to the community, but not only that, have conversation with one another. You know, I think there gets a point where you can't do everything by yourself.
True.
And so I think collaborations are a smart way to go, especially you see now, like you'll see a designer that now collaborates, say, with Adidas, or, you know, just those different types of collaborations. So why not do it on a level of small businesses that also have creative products, and allow those businesses to like feed off of each other, and also be in a collective environment. So the concept is just, you know, shop, eat, sip, vibe, so that we can showcase what we have going on. And then, you know, the hopeful is that these businesses will continue to obtain customers, and not only that, they become an investment to our community so that we are able to continue to invest in their products. Again, having that conversation, what's working, what's not working, how can we work with one another to ensure, you know, that everybody succeeds. And that's really what I'm about. I want sincerely everybody to win. You know, everybody can have empires.
And you covered a whole lot of ground. One of the key themes is, like you said, the importance of collaborating. And I can tell you just from like the audiobook, it's a world of difference working with people. And the ultimate, the underlying thing is win-win. It's win-win for that individual business. It's a win-win when businesses team up. Mm-hmm. It's sharing and exchanging. And it's a win-win with better connecting with the community. And it's the proverbial, there's an audience out there that needs to know who you are, what you do, and how to get connected. And that's huge. And I know that sounds like it's common knowledge, but what do they say about common sense ain't so common. And it's great that you're exercising that and then some. And I think it would be a good time, if we're able to, the promotional video that you have for the upcoming event. So if we can get that up and running, then I think that would be a great bridge and great segue.
Yeah, definitely.
And everything. So like I said, that'll be a great way for our viewers to kind of see the interactive pieces and just, like I said, just the collectives that you're doing. So you're basically setting the tone and leading by example.
Yeah, because you have the first, you know, you have, I have vendors of the first, you know, to be involved in it, so.
Well, that's great. Let's go to the video then. So let's take a look. Okay, cool. And then when we come back. Wow. Just taking a look at that, you were able to get that broad collection of other creatives. Wait, who did the video?
Oh, that would be me.
See, all look, leading by example. So it just looks like, look, it looks like a great event, arts, you know, the brunch theme, all that type of thing. So stress to our viewers the date, the time, location, and I tell you what, I'm going to be there, and I want, hey, I need y'all to be there too. So stress to our viewers all that info.
Okay, definitely. It is in Castleberry Hills at the Blank Canvas ATL. It's 321 Nelson Street, 30313. The event is from 12 p.m. to 3 p.m. You can purchase tickets at Eventbrite. You can look it up in two ways. It's cloth, C-L-O-T-H, the letter X, and then collaboratorsbrunch.eventbrite.com. Or, of course, you can do it easily and just put in cloth, C-L-O-T-H, and it should populate for you to pull up and get tickets. It's definitely good to get tickets earlier than at the door because it will cost you more. But again, it entails you being able to shop, sip, brunch, vibe. There's a DJ, you know, just a mix of different art. I wanted to make sure that I had different vendors. They all have different kind of artful elements to bring to this event. I'm excited. It's intimate, but it's chill. It's a good vibe. Come as you are. Come fly, because you know there's going to be pictures and videos.
Oh, yeah,
and
yeah,
all
definitely.
That good stuff. But yeah, again, it's August 24th, next Saturday, from 12 p.m. to 3 p.m. And there's free parking off of Nelson Street. They do have a parking deck, so that's always a plus in terms of finding parking. So come out, vibe, bring a friend, tell a friend. And again, you can go on my website if you need to find the invite. Again, it's the website is www.knowthecloth.com. So www.knowthecloth.com. And as well as you can find me on Instagram at knowthecloth.
Wow, that's a whole lot of great moving parts coming together, and it's clear that a great theme, a great collective, and it's a great launching point for even doing greater things.
It is.
So what we're going to do at this point, we're going to take our first commercial break, and when we come back, we'll have our next guest. So thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. And ladies and gentlemen, we are back on the Conversation Corner, Status Network, live TV. And as you can tell, today's show is definitely having an arts feel. And we've got another artiste in the building. Let people know who you are.
Hello, everybody. My name is Ted Taylor. I'm from Ackerman, Mississippi. Small town in Mississippi. May not even heard about it. Moved to Georgia 4 years ago in 2015, just really looking for something different.
Really something different? So wait, so you grew up in the SIP. See, this got Mississippi theme today. Brunch. We talked about the Mississippi Book Festival and, you know, the previous segment, you know, brunch. We're going to talk about some things you can sip on.
Yeah, most definitely, because Mississippi got it.
Yeah. So walk us through in regards to growing up in Mississippi. What was that pivot or that motivation to relocate?
Well, just coming up in Mississippi, it's great to live family. For me, that was the biggest thing that would have kept me there, but the opportunities wasn't as great as other places was.
Like, okay.
For instance, coming to Atlanta, I just woke up honestly one day in my room and decided that it's time for a change.
Okay.
So I called different places where I was working at just to see if they needed anyone. Mm-hmm. Did an over the phone interview and got the job and moved to Atlanta. And that was my story to how I got here. And just since I've been here, just running across so many different people, you can network a lot here.
Like, wow.
Yeah.
And networking, and I know we hear the word, but I'll tell you what, when it's done right,
yeah,
you can do some major things. So walk through with our viewers. So now you were looking for something different. Mm-hmm. Had a great phone interview, so your public speaking skills are kind of important.
Yeah, most definitely.
Moved out here. You're getting situated. You're networking and interfacing. Walk us through what were some of the next steps.
The next steps for me, it was just basically taking something that me and a good friend of mine, John Kincaid, I will always include him in everything when it comes to this, because he was a big inspiration on me starting this way. Started out as, you know, us coming together as a group, wanting to give back to our community. So basically, you know, being mentors to, you know, younger versions of ourselves, letting them know that it's different ways to make it. Definitely wanting to show them how to be gentlemen, how to be young women out here. So so with that, we decided to go through the clothing route. Fashion is a great outlet for, you know, just creative minds. You can show and demonstrate and deliver a message a lot through fashion. So that was the biggest thing for us. And once we, you know, sat down and decided to come up with different designs, logos, messages behind everything that we put out. So that was the turning point for us. Once we got everything developed, we met with, you know, designers, we met with people to produce it for us. And we set up, you know, the websites, and we set up the social media, getting different contacts that way. And from there, it just kind of grew, and people were enjoying and also liking our designs and our concepts, and we just grew from there.
And here's something that's real important. One of the thing is, really, it all started with what you said. All of you had a passion to want to invest in the community. And in the people,
right?
And I kidded around when I was doing the advanced drops of like merch with the message, but like for real, like your merch has a message, and some of the themes you were talking about, you know, carrying yourself and how to, you know, appropriately engage in all of that, and I think that ties in with the brand that you've got right there. So walk us through the some of the, I'll say the offshoots of the concept of wanting to give back, wanting to invest, wanting to uplift and encourage. And like you said, your canvas happens to be clothing. So where some canvas might be, you know, on record or painting or sculpting or whatever, yours canvas, explain to our viewers your canvas.
So basically just looking at fashion, like I said, you can, it's a lot of different ways to show your creativity through it. And with ours, we decided to go this way because in our culture anyway, we have so many influences on a lot.
We were talking about that offline, but yes, there's a whole lot. And that's an understatement. So walk us through one of the concepts you have, which is King. Walk us through a little bit behind the thought process, rationale, and the message that you're trying to deliver.
Right. So with the King design, so this is just a what we decided to say was just a bold statement. Just letting you know once you see it, it's just it's plain and simple, but it's also yet a powerful message to let you know that, you know, it's a king amongst yourselves. So and we also have the queen. And what we did with the logo, the design of it, we took out the I and the U and the queen, and we put Africa.
And that's huge. I'm gonna pause you right there, and that's saying a lot. And that is also an understatement, because you're looking at it, let me take a guess, part of it, Africa is going to be connectivity to your roots, your culture, the birthplace of civilization. So even in that simple, technically three-letter word, and that symbol, y'all are like dropping the hammer is an understatement.
Most definitely, because I feel that, you know, with the history that we are taught, it's not our history. So with this, we want to create a platform to where we get your attention first. Once you see it, like the first thing you see in it for me was the Africa. So once you see that, it's so many stories and ideas and things that have told us about Africa that it's not true, and we really don't know.
Exactly.
So once you see, you know, somebody come in with a positive message for Africa, it gets you, like, you want to research it a little bit more. And with the word king, who were the kings and the queens of Africa? Because we were kings and queens before we were slaves, which once you start in school, that's the first thing you learn about Black history, that we came over on ships. but they don't ever talk about how we were kings and queens.
I'm going to pause you there because you make a valid point, because when you really think about, we'll say, the whatever curriculum or what have you, it's like, okay, you were forcibly brought here, but there was a life before then. And unless, without going too deep, unless you read stuff like Stolen Legacy or Before the Mayflower or, you know, pieces along those lines, what you're trying to do is bridge that gap and eliminate that disconnect that's there. So, yeah, y'all are hitting hard with like a three-letter word. Okay, it's technically four, but a three-letter word could have that hard-hitting an impact. And even on the – and for women, like you said, you have the queen as well. So it's like right. Y'all walk in step. It's like you – go ahead. I'm sorry.
No. You right on point with it. You have to be equally yoked. You know, we can only be as strong as our partner. And with that, you know, and that's what with our programs, that's what we want to teach, where, you know, we can teach our young men to, you know, respect yourselves, but also respect your young woman. And with, you know, with the ladies, you know, respect yourselves, also respect your young man. So if you guys can come together collectively, have one common goal together collectively, mm-hmm. we can achieve so much more. And like that alone in itself would be great. Like the results from it, it's like it's unthinkable. Like it's so great that you know, to think about what you can accomplish if you just actually come together and work together for that one common goal.
So it sounds like the art of collaboration.
Most definitely.
That's definitely been a theme tonight. Look, if y'all didn't know what the word collaboration means, you are getting an education tonight. Seriously. So it's great. So again, the thing that is so captivating is you have the themes that you're trying to do anyway. You're using clothing as your canvas, as that bridge, as that conversation piece. And now, in addition to the clothing, do you have any other, I'll say, programs or extension programs to really reinforce, you know, some of these types of things? Or?
Right. Yeah. So we have what we call it, just different phases on how we're going to work. So like right now, it's just the clothing aspect.
Okay.
And the reason we decided to go with this first is because, I mean, if you look at it, we as a culture, we really we can take a brand name. And like we take
you, you know what? And you know what, the first thing that came to mind, and I know I'm kind of dating myself, but I remember this hip hop group by the name of Run DMC.
Right.
And when they did the song My Adidas. Everyone put their kicks in the air, and the Adidas execs were like, whoa. And then all of a sudden, like, the Run DMC brand came out.
And there you go.
And there like, you have it.
For my time, it was Nelly and Air Force One.
Okay, yeah.
You know, so, you know, when that song came out, it's like, yo, I have to go get a pair of Air Force Ones.
Uh-huh.
So, like, when you see that our culture and how we influence and drive a market, like, because I remember when Air Force Ones was $75.
Right.
And now look at them. They're
like a card note.
Yeah, exactly. So you look at that, and so if we can, you know, grab the people's attention by our apparel, then we can start sending out, you know, the different messages.
Right.
We can, you know, start building the after school programs that we want to do. That's just one. That's, you know, that's a big goal of ours. And the next thing too is we want to take care of the homeless. Like mm-hmm. that's major too. So, you know, as a king, in my eyes, a king is a servant. And what I mean by that, if you're going to be a leader, you have to take care of your people, and your people will take care of your kingdom. So when we see just you have abandoned houses and then you have homeless people, like something's missing right there.
So, yeah.
So if we can develop, you know, like I said, come together and we can get the people's attention and let them know like how powerful we are. We are kings and queens. So let's get together and let's build our kingdom back. And so and you just like with the programs that we want and will definitely have in place, we will rectify a lot of that. And it have to, you start with the youth. So that's why we want to start with our after school program.
Right.
So if we can, you know, get them on the right path, it's Man, it's limitless.
And the good thing is, even with where you are now, like you said, you're already planting seeds. So you think about when someone's wearing the shirt or the hoodie or whatever, that's already seed planting because it's going to spark curiosity. It's going to spark interest. It's going to spark what else is out there. And now you're drawn. It's almost like an education hook and hold. You're hooking people mm-hmm. with, okay, just the shirt. Right. Or just, you know, the merch or what have you. And now that's that conversation piece. And now when you have your resources together, now, like you said, the next step is this. Then the next step is this. So when you talk about influencing culture, y'all, when I say, like, merch with a message, I mean, that's not just a catchphrase. Now, if you want to borrow that, you know, we can talk. but all kidding aside, it's like you guys are delivering a message and you're starting subtle and kind of breaking ground right now. Yeah, and now once the ground is cultivated and you throw a little bit here and there, now we're going to be able to add our next step. And then from there, our next step. So you've got a lot. You've got some great things from just a simple idea. So just
that's it, inception.
And it's like you said, it kind of all started with a want to be elsewhere and a phone call.
That's
so answer your phones. Wait, I better answer mine at some point. So no, but that's really, it's a powerful story. It's a creative story. And you guys are already putting things in motion. You're making the abstract more concrete.
Right.
And the biggest thing is, you know, as I say, as a man thinketh, and you can paraphrase that, as a woman thinketh. So I'm glad y'all are thinking and doing and making it happen. As we get ready to, we got a minute or two. So you've got clothing right now. So obviously you've got the t-shirts. What are part of the other, and I know we've got them scrolling, but what are some of the other parts fashion wise that y'all have?
So fashion, we like you said, we have the t-shirts, we have the hoodies, mm-hmm. we have jackets, we're gonna have hats, visors, backpacks. It's gonna be a number of merch that okay. we got stickers out on the market. So like, I mean, we're definitely going to try to tap into any piece of product that we can. We'll have some type of formula apparel.
When are those backpacks coming out? Because you know what I'm thinking already off the cuff with that backpack, obviously with kids, but you think about when you have the backpacks, would you look into doing, let's say, like a back to school and that see creative minds right here,
creative minds
right here, and think, and it all start, this conversation started on a hot, it was hot as all get out back on July 20th at Bronx Day. Shouts to my he's been a guest on the show, DJ Majestic, for having me out of Bronx Day. And this brother right here, when you first started talking, at first I thought you were from up top.
Yeah.
And then you like, no, I'm from Mississippi. And Mississippi. I said, the Sip. And you eyes live is like, oh, what you know about the Sip? And we went back and forth. And I'm saying all that to say you the proverbial, this is what we like doing here. The whole point of this show is we're having the conversation and having the dialogue and sharing and exchanging. Mm-hmm. And the fact that we put that into practice and play, now all of a sudden, here we are. And more people can be aware of having a conversation with you. So before we go mm-hmm. to our next break and before we do our PSAs and wind down with our previous guest, let our viewers know where are the best ways for people to connect, engage, and support the work that y'all are doing.
Okay, yeah, most definitely. The best way is through IG, and that is 4_me_apparel. You also can check us out on Facebook, which is just 4me_apparel. We have a page there. And also our website, www.4meapparel.com.
Okay, there you got it. So what we're going to do is we're going to take another commercial break. When we come back, we'll do our public service announcements and we'll do our recap with both of our guests. So here you are at the Conversation Corner, Status Network, live TV. this show. I don't know about y'all. We have fun. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, we are back on the Conversation Corner with your host, author Andrew Snorton, Status Network Live TV. Obviously, we are having a creative show when creative minds come together. Before we do our recap, we're going to do a few public service announcements and then recap with both of our guests. So, for our first public service announcement. And yes, we mentioned a little bit earlier, Third Level Entertainment Group and author Andrew Snorton present the author's mixtape, Volume 1, Organic Musings from H2O. Make sure to keep abreast on the social media, the website, and thank you for MailChimp. We have a distribution list. So that release date is coming soon. Earlier in the show, you heard the intro. And I tell you what, for someone to make it up as they went along, because everything was done in one take, we have the video to show it. You need to make sure you cop the album and audiobook, or they're one and the same. But definitely make sure to catch it. Our next public service announcement is September. Do you remember the 5th day of September? Well, you better, because I'm rolling down to the South Side, Metro Atlanta. Shouts to Marcus Williams at Nubian Bookstore. They're one of the bookstores carrying both of my books. So join me after work at Nubian Bookstore on September the 5th from 5 to 7 p.m. Book signing, and I will have the audiobook available as well, and both books are up for awards. Our next public service announcement. Oh my goodness, wait, September is homecoming season, and shouts to the alma mater Wake Forest University, as I'll be doing a book signing on Homecoming Friday right there at the college bookstore. So y'all know the deal, right there on the quad from 1 to 4 p.m. Well, the bookstore's at the quad. So before you go to party so dear, make sure to check me out from 1 to 4 p.m. at the Wake Forest University on-campus bookstore. As a side note, a portion of the on-campus sales will go to help support the efforts of Intercultural Affairs, the School of Divinity, and the Magnolia Scholars Program. So shouts to my classmate and line brother, Dr. Nate French. So that means everybody in Winston, Kernersville, Walkertown, heck, y'all in the Triad, High Point, Greensboro, because you know GHOE ain't going on until October, so y'all need to roll and holler at your boy. Excuse me. Have a conversation with me. So make sure to check me out on September 20th. The next public service announcement. From our friends at Majority Greek Magazine, be on the lookout Friday, August 23rd. Their charity mini golf tournament is taking place at Pirates Cove Adventure Golf. Remember, that's where you used to go before you went to Topgolf. But this is actually more fun because it's all about the kids. So grand prize, a $500 prize package, and a portion of the proceeds are helping to support Fit Kid Fresh. So then again, get your putt-putt game, miniature game on, your short game on. Oh, it doesn't sound good. Anyway, your putt-putt game on, but Friday the 23rd, you need to make sure you are there. So shouts to our friends at Majority Greek. Our next public service announcement. Our friends down in Birmingham, Magic City. So before you even think about the Magic City Classic, that's in October. Next weekend, for all members of our Greek Letter organization, so shouts to our members from Alpha Phi Alpha, Alpha Kappa Alpha, Kappa Alpha Psi, Omega Psi Phi, Delta Sigma Theta. You know I had to have that right. Delta Sigma Theta. Oh my goodness. Phi Beta Sigma, Zeta Phi Beta, Sigma Gamma Rho, and Iota Phi Theta. Grown and Greek. This is taking place in Birmingham next weekend, pretty much August 22nd through 25th. It's not just a party, y'all. They have community pieces that are going on that Thursday. And the reason why I'm using this one is Saturday, Serve and Supply. So Saturday the 24th from 12 to 4 p.m. Those of you in Birmingham, Bessemer, shoot, those of you in Tuscaloosa, it's not football going on, so you need to make sure to make your way there. And it is actually open to the general public, but it's definitely a spotlight on the Greeks. So shout to Grown and Greek, and shout to DJ Chocolate, my family member, for looking out. And there you have it for our public service announcements. So with the minutes that we've got, I definitely want to make sure that we recap a couple of things. And as I said, we've got two creative minds doing some creative things. Charla, in addition to what you've got going on, again, August 24th, definitely you know, remind our viewers the importance of the 24th, not only for that event, but what's one of the things that it's helping support in addition to all those different moving parts?
Cool. So next Saturday, August 24th, is Cloth times Collaborators. It's a fashionable brunch marketplace. Again, the concept really came as I had an intern this year, and I wanted to find a way to where creative businesses could connect with our future generation in terms of those going into the creative fields. And I also wanted to be able to bring creative businesses together so that we can converse, have a conversation, do multiple things collectively. So Cloth is just that whole mix. The purpose, again, is to build a community to where we are coming together to, again, have conversations, know about services and products that we carry, know about these creative businesses, as well as the creative businesses that are involved, which are my vendor collaborators, that they also start to connect with our college students that are coming out as seniors, that are looking for other creatives to kind of shadow. My intern wanted to shadow me. She's a graduate from Georgia Southern in May, and mm-hmm. she received her degree also in fashion design and fashion merchandising. And it was important for her to find somebody, one, that looked like her, as well as had the vision and idea of becoming an entrepreneur as a fashion designer. And so, again, I was referred from a classmate to her to interview with me to see if we were a good fit. And so working with her throughout those months and leading up to her graduation, her and I kind of, you know, she made me see that there was a need for creative businesses to connect to those students. So Cloth kind of was the vessel and extension of that idea, and then also the importance of us in terms of creative businesses and minority businesses, women in businesses, to really put ourselves out there in the community, and also for us to come as a collaborative and have conversations with each other and know how to talk to each other when it comes to services that we give, products that we provide, and do it in a way, but a cool vibe, because I'm a cool kind of female. So I wanted to do that whole mix. So of course, you know, DJ, shopping, sipping, eating, vibing, and of course shopping is the purpose of next week.
And I'm glad that you mentioned, in addition to reinforcing those themes of creatives coming together and better engaging with each other in the community, another thing is seed planting for that next generation of creatives. Tim, quick thing that you wanted to make sure to really stress and emphasize for our viewers.
So the biggest thing is just make sure you go to our IG page. Like I said, it's 4_me_apparel. Definitely look out for, you know, new product that's coming, also new content that's coming, where we're going to be delivering a lot of messages. Looking at our history, we're going to be talking about a lot of different kings and queens throughout our history. That's definitely something that we're going to be pushing to get the knowledge out there and the awareness. And so that's the biggest thing that, you know, I want our viewers to know and to be on the lookout for.
Okay.
And I love his shirt.
Yeah.
I was like, you have a queen one?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. We're going to take care of, I guess, here.
Definitely. And one of the things, especially when you explained the concept behind really investing in the community, and this is the first step of having that discussion, conversation, and it's still seed planting. It's bridge building. And you both are doing some awesome things, and I'm very, very grateful for both of you to take time out of your schedules to be here. Real quick, Tim, best ways for people to engage with the work that you all are doing?
All right, to engage with us, check us out on Facebook, For Me Apparel, also IG, For_Me_Apparel, and also www.formeapparel.com.
Okay, and Charla, the best ways for people to engage and connect, especially regarding the event on August 24th.
Definitely. To get your tickets for next week, you could go on Eventbrite. It's Cloth times Collaborators Brunch. www.eventbrite.com. Also, another easier way is head to the website is www.knowthecloth.com. And then, of course, you can always find me on IG, whether Know the Cloth or at CRCCO. That's me as a fashion designer, because, of course, that's what I do. But any of those channels we can be reached at, and definitely get you set for next week's fashionable brunch marketplace.
Well, and there you have it, awesome. Ladies and gentlemen. So as we get ready to wrap up with the conversation corner, as with all of our guests, please don't let this be the only time you see or see about them. Please connect with our guests tonight. Please connect with our previous guests, as this is what we do here, entertainment, business, community, and more. The next time that we will air will be the fourth Wednesday of the month, which will be August 28th at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We thank you for making the time to view the show. All of you, take care, be safe out there, and we will see you next time, and we'll have a conversation on the 28th.